Today we'll study third poem of grade 9 entitled Rain on the Roof. This poem is composed by Coates Kinney. Poet Coates Kinney is basically from New York, USA. And in this poem, poet observes that when starry sky is covered with rain-bearing cloud, their moisture fell down as their tears. It is very pleasing, comforting and thrilling experience to lie in one's home with head pressed on pillow and listen to the pitter-patter of rain. These falling raindrops trigger a number of imaginary things into poet's mind. The soft pitter-patter of rain revives many childhood memories to poet, and at last this rain builds up a bridge between his past and his present. So friends, this was the summary of this poem. Now let's study it in more detail. So first we'll see the rhyme scheme of this poem. As you know that this poem contains three stanzas, so we'll start with the first one. First word is hover, ending sound is ar, so we'll label it by letter A. Next word is spears, new sound, new letter, that is B. Next word is darkness, again new sound, new letter, C. Tears, where tears and spears, they are rhyming word, so we'll repeat the letter B. Next word is pillow. Pillow is a new sound here, so we'll repeat, take a new letter, that is D. Next is bed. New sound, next letter, that is E. Here patter. Patter and hover, they are ending with the same sound, so we'll repeat the letter E. Last word is overhead. Overhead and bed, they are rhyming word, so we'll repeat the letter E. So rhyme scheme of this stanza is A B C B D E A E. Now second stanza, first word is shingles. We'll label it by letter A. Next is heart. New sound, next letter, that is B. Next is fences. Again new sound, next letter, that is C. Next is start. Start and heart, they are rhyming word, so we'll repeat the letter B. Next is recollections. New sound, next letter, that is D. Woof. New sound, new letter, E. Patter. Here patter is again new sound, so we'll take the next letter, that is F. Last is roof. Here roof and woof, they are rhyming word, so we'll repeat the letter E. So rhyme scheme of this stanza is A B C B D E F E. Moving to the third stanza, first word is mother. We will label it by letter A. Next is ago. New sound, new letter, that is B. Next is dreamers. Again new sound, next letter, that is C. Now dawn. Here dawn and ago, they are rhyming words, so we will repeat the letter B. Next is me. Here me is a new sound, next letter, that is B. Refrain. Refrain is again a new sound, next letter, that is E. Shingles. Shingles is again a next new sound, so next letter, that is F. Last is rain. Refrain and rain, they are a rhyming word, so we will repeat the letter E. So rhyme scheme of this stanza is A B C B B E F E. So as you can see, rhyme scheme of stanza second and third is same, but of stanza one there is a little difference because of A. So friends, this was the rhyme scheme of this poem. Now let's see the explanation of the poem. So now it's time for explanation, and the poem starts like, when the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres. Humid shadows means black rainy clouds. And hover means to float in the sky. Over all the starry spheres. Starry spheres means sky full of stars. Means when black clouds come and they cover all the starry sphere.
And the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. Here darkness word is used for showing the night time. And melancholy is used here to show as if the clouds are painted as they are set. Gently weeps in rainy tears. Here poet means when the black cloud comes and poet feel like they are sad and their moisture fell down as their tear. But we feel like it's raining. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. What a bliss means what a happiness. Bliss means happiness. And cottage chamber mean bedroom. Now poet is lying in his bedroom by pressing his head under his pillow to keep his body warm, to fight back the chill of the nature. And lie listening to the patter of soft rain overhead. By pressing his head under his pillow, he is listening to the patter of rain. Patter means sound of rain, which is falling on his roof. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart. Every tinkle means every single shining raindrop. Singles means tiles like structures. As an echo. Echo means repetition of one sound. Now poet says when every single shining raindrop fell, he has the echo in his heart. And a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. Dreamy fancies means many imaginary things. And busy being here means mind of poet which is full of thoughts. With the same echo, many imaginary things started to come in poet's mind. And a thousand recollections weave their ear threads into woof. Recollections means past memories, or you can say childhood memories. Woof means a canvas made up of threads. Now with those imaginary things, many childhood memories also started to come in poet's mind, which was full of many thoughts. And they form a very beautiful canvas in his mind. As I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof, and this whole thing happened when poet was listening to the patter of rain, sound of rain which was falling on his roof. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years ago. As we know now, poet's mind was full of many memories. Now in one of his memory comes his mother, as she used to come in his childhood. Here ago means ago. Years ago, years back. To regard the darling dreamers. She left them till the dawn. Now his mother used to come in his childhood to say her darling dreamers means poet and his siblings. His mother used to come in his childhood to say them bye bye, good night and sweet dream till the morning. Air means before and dawn means till the morning. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain. Now poet say, I can still feel her loving face which she used to look at me in my childhood. Here I means poet himself. As I list to this refrain, list means here short form of listen, listen. Refrain, sound of music. Now here which music? The sound of raindrops. And he can feel all these things when he was listening to the sound of rain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. And this music is played upon the shingles by the drops of rain, by the sound of rain. So friends, this was the explanation of the poem. Now let's see the poetic devices used in this poem. First one is alliteration. Next is onomatopoeia. The last is transferred epithet. Starting with the alliteration, alliteration as we know, it is the repetition of starting sound of any word. So the first example of alliteration is starry spheres. Here sound of sa is repeated in both the word. So it is an example of alliteration. Next is press pillow. Here sound of pa is repeated in both the words. So it is also an example of alliteration. Next one is busy bee. Where sound of b is repeated in both the word. So it is also an example of alliteration. Next is memory, my mother. In these three words, sound of m is repeated. So it is again an example of alliteration. And the last example is feel phone. Here sound of fa is repeated. So this is also an example of alliteration. Now next one is onomatopoeia. This is a new poetic devices which we are studying. And onomatopoeia means any natural sound. So in this poem, natural sound is of rain. So here patter. Patter is an example of onomatopoeia. Next example is tinkle. Tinkle also means sound of raindrops which are falling on the shingles. So it is also an example of onomatopoeia. And the last one is transferred epithet. The epithet means adjective. And transferred means anything used at wrong place. So it means adjective which is used at wrong place. So the example of transferred epithet is melancholy darkness. As you know, darkness was used in this poem for night scene. And night cannot be said. So a poet who said not the night. So a melancholy is used at wrong place. So it is an example of transferred epithet. Next example is dreamy fancies. As you know that fancies was used in this poem for imaginary thing. And imaginations can't dream. So here poet was dreaming, not the imagination. So dreamy word is used here at wrong place. So it is also an example of transferred epithet. So friend, these were some of the poetry devices used in the poem. Now let's discuss the theme of the poem. After the deep study of poem, we'll come to know that the theme of poem is the healing power of rain. The musical sound produced by the raindrops which are falling on roof in night has an ability to revive the sweet memories in one's otherwise busy mind. The rain thus soothes and comforts the overworked mind by taking it back to its life's beautiful time. With the theme, the poem also carries a small message, that is, the rain has a therapeutic and healing power, and it also forms long-lasting memories in human mind, which are spent at sights, sounds, fragrance, and especially which are spent with our loving ones. So friends, I hope you understood the poem very well. So like the video, share it, and subscribe the channel. Thank you.